Welcome to Zion's Cause Baptist Church. Celebrating the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ for 135 years. We are glad that you are with us today. We invite you to join with us in prayer. Praise and worship of our Lord and Savior. And grow with us as we receive the message today from God's Word.
Played out the vintage where the grapes of wrath are stored. He has loosed the faithful lightning of his terrible with sword. His truth is marching on, and we sing glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. And glory. Coming like the glory of the morning on the way. He is wisdom to the mighty, he is honor to the brave. So the world shall be his footstool and the soul along his slave. Our God is marching on. And glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. And God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans, wide with hope. Sweet home, God bless America, my home, sweet home.
Well, happy Independence Day, everyone. It's so glad to see you. A lot of you are wearing, sporting the red and the white and the blue today, so it's good to see you this morning. Good for all those that are joining this morning. We're glad that you're tuning in. We're going to take a moment and just welcome those around us this morning. So just turn around, say hello, and just wave at everyone as we make you welcome to be in church this morning. We all know this one, let's sing it.
He's coming on the clouds, kings and kingdoms will bow down. And every chain will break as broken hearts declare his praise. For who can stop the Lord Almighty? Our God is the Lion, of Judah. He's roaring with power and fighting our battles, and every knee will bow before him. Our God is the Lamb that was slain for the sin of his world. His blood breaks his chains, and every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb. Every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb.
So open up. So open up those gates. Make way before the King of Kings. Our God who comes to save, He's here to set the captives free. Or who can stop the Lord Almighty? Our God is the Lion of Judah. He's roaring with power, and He's fighting our battles, and every knee will bow before Him. Our God is the Lamb that was slain for the sin of this world. His blood breaks those chains, and every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb. Oh, every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb. We say, who can stop the Lord Almighty? 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 Oh, and who can stop the Lord Almighty? Who can stop the Lord Almighty? Oh, and who can stop the Lord Almighty? Or who can stop the Lord? Our God is the Lion of Judah. He's roaring with power, and He's fighting our battles, and every knee will bow before Him. Our God is the Lamb that was slain for the sin of this world. His blood breaks those chains, and every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb. Oh, every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb. And every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb. Amen. You can be seated. Be seated there this morning. You know, this week we had Bible school, and I know Brother Charles will talk about that, but I'm telling you, I just had the very best. Who had a great Bible school this week? I think it may have been the best Bible school I've ever been to. And I think part of that was we missed it last year so much. And, you know, I was thinking about that and thinking about this week, and in Bible school, we kept coming up with those scriptures about be strong, be courageous, and He fights our battles. And we started thinking about songs this week, and I love Lion the Lamb. We do that so much, but I love that part in there that He make way for the King because He fights our battles. And that's so important. And I just want to read you a couple of scriptures that we talked about this week that just stood out to me, and I loved it. Bible school, we talked about when you go out into battle against your enemies, He says, do not be afraid or panic or terrible or tremble. I'm there. Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or tremble at them. For the Lord your God is the one who goes with you. He will not fail us. He will not forsake us. I can do all things through Christ who strengthened me. And I had some, I love Bible school because I get a lot of questions. And all ages. And the questions you get is, how do I know God hears me? When dark times come in my life, how do I know God is there? And I had one older kid said, what do I do when my world just overwhelms me? And I'm thinking, man, that's so heavy for students to have those questions in the world they live in. And we talked about what I do. I go to God in prayer. I sing praises to Him. I read His word. And I thought of this little chorus, and I want us to sing it today as our prayer song this morning. But I love what the words say as we look at that this morning. It just goes, and this is how I fight my battles. We go to the Lord and fight them for us.
This is how I fight my battle. This is how I fight my battle. This is how I fight my battles. And when the enemy comes and we look surrounded, we see, it may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. I love that. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. Sing that this morning. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. In church, and this is how we fight our battles. We fight them together. Go. Oh, and this is how we fight our battles. This is how we fight our battles. This is how we fight our battles. And when the devil comes to surround us, oh, church, it may look like we're surrounded, but we're surrounded by you. It may look like we're surrounded, but we're surrounded by you. It may look like we're surrounded, but we're surrounded by you. It may look like we're surrounded, but we're surrounded by you.
Don't you love that promise of those words? I love it. When the enemy comes and it looks like there's nowhere to go, he's with us. He said, I've got your battles. So that was just comforting me this week, and I wanted to share that with you. But thank you so much for all those that just were part of our Bible school. I was just blessed all week, I'll just tell you. You know, Brother Charles was talking this morning. The numbers kept going up every night. Amen. And it was just a wonderful, wonderful week. So we thank you for that. Brother Charles, will you come and speak and lead us in prayer there, brother?
We echo those words and say, praise the Lord. Start out, I don't know, 125, 30 on Sunday night. And by the time Wednesday night got here, we was around 200 that came out to enjoy pizza and things. And we just praise the Lord for all the hard work that had gone into Vacation Bible School, and looking forward to reaping, just continued reaping the harvest of the seeds that were planted this past week. Had a great time with adult Bible study, had great groups every night in adult Bible study, and so we just praise the Lord. So good to see you with us. Glad to have our YouTube channel that is on right now. We say good morning to you, as well as Mediacom Channel 8. We are grateful that we can be sharing our service with you today. And then those of you that are here with us in sanctuary as we worship the Lord together. Let's go to Him in a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we bow before you, and Father, this week has been a great week for Zion's Cause Baptist Church, and we have seen a lot of boys and girls come through our doors, and they've heard some wonderful, wonderful passages of Scripture about how that you care for them, how that you love them, how that you died for them. And so, Father, today we just continue to pray for the seeds that were sowed, and may we continue to cultivate those seeds as they grow. And Lord, we're just looking for more things of your wonders, of your grace, of seeing coming out of Vacation Bible School. Father, it's great to be here. I'm glad to be with my brothers and sisters here in this sanctuary, those who are watching our YouTube. Father, we're grateful for all of them, as well as those watching Mediacom Channel 8. And Father, it was just great that we can be together and we can worship you right now. In Jesus' name, amen.
As you remain seated, we're going to introduce a new song this week, and hopefully something that the church will love as we learn it together over the next few weeks. But it's a great song, and especially with today's theme, and it talks about who the battle belongs to. So let's do that together.
I see is the battle. You see my victory. When all I see is the mountain, you see a mountain blue. And as I walk through the shadow, your love surrounds me. There's nothing to fear now, for I am safe with you. So when I fight, I'll fight on my knees, with my hands lifted high. And oh God, the battle belongs to you. And every fear I lay at your feet, I'll sing through the night. And oh God, the battle belongs to you. And if you are for me, who can be against me? For Jesus, there is nothing impossible for you. When all I see are the ashes, you see the beauty. When all I see is the cross, you see the empty tomb. So when I fight, I'll fight on my knees, with my hands lifted high. And no
thankful that we claim these promises today, that when we're in the fight, when we're in the battle, that you are with us. You help us to be strong and courageous, Father. And Father, you won't leave us alone. Father, you'll be right there leading the charge. And Father, we're thankful for what that means in our lives. We're thankful for the freedom we celebrate today on this July the 4th, on this Sunday at church, that we get to celebrate our independence, not only with our country, but our independence that comes from the cross, Father, and what that means to us. So we celebrate that today. Just be with our pastor as he brings the message. Be with us as we take communion today. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Brother Jason, leading us today. And this is the 4th of July weekend, and we are celebrating. We're very, very thankful for the freedom that we have in America. And we're definitely very thankful for our military serving and defending this great nation. If you have served in the military, we would like to honor you. Would you please stand at this time that we may honor you today? Please stand. Yes, indeed. Let's give them a hand of applause today. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And we appreciate your service to our country and appreciate our military so, so very much. And this weekend, just celebrating that, because we do have a great freedom. A great freedom. Folks, there's, you know, not every church in the world can do what we are doing right now in an open assembly and gathering and publicly and singing and praying and talking about the name of Jesus Christ and talking about God. That doesn't happen all around the world. Some are very, very limited in what that they can do in meeting in privately, but we don't have to do that because of our freedom in this country, and we are not to take that for granted, but we are to utilize that and exercise our freedom for that, and because with that is a great, great responsibility. And so we're looking at that today. You see, I have the colors behind me. We have the American flag. We have the Christian flag. As we think of the American flag representing America, as we look at it, it is a symbol of our nation. And as you think of the colors that are there, the red, white, and blue, the colors of the flag are very, very symbolic as well, as the red symbolizes hardiness and valor, white symbolizes purity and innocence, and the blue represents vigilance, perseverance, and justice. As we know, the stripes of our flag represents the original 13 colonies that gathered together here in America. Also, the stars represent the 50 states of our union. But then also you look at the Christian flag. The Christian flag as well has red, white, and blue. And as we think of the Christian flag, it is taken from a white fabric. And as we think of the white, it is a white field. And there is also a red cross that is on that white field. It is a red Latin cross. And then also there is a blue canton around that cross. Of course, we know that the shade of red on the cross symbolizes the blood of Jesus Christ. We're going to be observing the Lord's table here at the end of our service today. And we encourage all baptized believers in Jesus Christ. You do not necessarily have to be a member of this congregation to participate in the Lord's Supper, because we believe here in practice that it is something between you and the Lord. But as we think of the colors, as we think of red, the blood of Jesus Christ, the blues representing the waters of baptism as well as the faithfulness of Christ, and also the white represents Jesus's purity. And so as we think, they are meaning, they are to have meaning in our life, they are symbols as we reflect upon it this great weekend. Well, let us also reflect upon the Word of God today. We're going to be looking at Galatians chapter 5 and going to be reading verse number 1. It says, "Stand fast, therefore, in the liberty by which Christ has made us free, and do not be entangled again with a yoke of bondage." Let's pray. Father, we come to you. We thank you for this weekend. Father, we thank you that we live here in America and we enjoy these freedoms, the freedom to worship, the freedom to gather in a public assembly, and Father, we exercise those rights today, but we thank you for that freedom. We also thank you for the freedom that we have in the Christian life, and we're going to be talking about that today, Lord, and may we not take it for granted, may we not neglect it, but may we see what we have and may we cherish it as a great treasure in our lives. And we pray these things in Jesus' name and amen. Amen. First thing, as we begin looking in this passage of Scripture today, our first point for today, we see a God-given freedom. A God-given freedom today that we want to talk about. In that God-given freedom, notice what Paul is writing to the churches of Galatia, because they had problems over in Galatia. There were churches over there that had some serious problems, and he is addressing those problems with those churches. He says, "Stand fast, therefore, in the liberty by which Christ has made us free. Christ has made us free. Now, as we sometimes we don't think about the freedom. A lot of times we don't think about the freedom that we have here as Americans. But we want to go to a greater degree talking about the freedom that we have as believers in Jesus Christ. Because there were some in Paul's day, what they were doing there, they were saying, yes, you have the gospel, you have the plan of salvation here, but we want to add the old law back in. And in order for you to maintain it, in order for you to keep it, you need to be carrying out the law of Moses in your life. And he addresses that. He says, do not be entangled again with a yoke of bondage. Now, as we think of the freedom, as we come in here today, we pray, we praise, do we think about the freedom? Do we think about how free that we are in Christ Jesus by being in God's family? In God's family. God gives that to us. He didn't have to, but guess what? That was his plan. That is what he developed for us in our life, that we might have this freedom. As he talks about here in this passage of Scripture, we see some thoughts that he has given to us. Secondly, as we look at this, he says, stand firm. Stand firm. As the Scripture says here, that we are to stand fast, therefore, in the liberty. Now, the Apostle Paul would use a lot of things that were known in that day. Paul used athletic terminology as well, but he also used military terminology too. And this is military terminology as we think of stand fast. Now, those of you that have watched old movies and you've seen the great Roman Empire and you've seen the great Roman army and the configurations that they would make, and as they would come across the field and as they were advancing to battle there, you would see the foot soldiers as they would be going and they would be marching towards the enemy, and those Roman soldiers would have this great big spear in their hands that they would throw at one point, but then they would always have that shield, and they would take that shield, and those foot soldiers, they would link those shields together and they would proceed towards to the enemy there, and seeing that, they were defending, and there was a wall, a wall of steel that was coming across there. And it fortified them so that they could fight the battle. Well, today, as we know as believers in Jesus Christ, we are waging a war against the forces of evil, against Satan himself there, and you and I today, we are to be standing fast. The Apostle Paul wrote in this book as well about the spiritual warfare that we are dealing with each and every day. But notice what he says, stand firm, stand firm, stand fast, know what you believe. Hear what this is, it's talking about theology here, because they had become entangled with a yoke of bondage, yoke of bondage. You and I, Christ did not design for us to live in bondage, but Christ has designed for you and me to live in freedom, live in freedom. But let me also talk about responsibility for just a little bit. The Bible teaches us, unto whom much is given, much is required. Now, living here in America, much is given. Amen? Much is given. We live in a country that we have been given much. We enjoy so much more than other countries in the world. And we have that blessing. But unto whom much is given, much is required, which means the blessings, if we have blessings up here, there is responsibility up here equal to that of those blessings. Now, that is just not only of being that of American citizen, but as a believer in Jesus Christ, God says, unto whom much is given, much is required. And because of this freedom that we have been given to us, there is much that is required of us. There is a responsibility that we have, and the Apostle Paul is trying to identify that. Now, in this passage of Scripture, we see immediately two things that are going on. We see the bondage of legalism at the end of this, and that's what it was. It was the bondage of legalism that they were dealing with, that they were all tangled up with the yoke of bondage by trying to bring in that law of Moses. But then on the other hand, there is a warning here that we do not have uncontrolled expressions of liberty, of freedom, which means someone might say, well, because I believe in Jesus Christ and I'm a part of the family of God, I can do whatever I want, whenever I want, how I want. It's all paid for. I can do whatever. You will never find in the Word of God, I can do whatever. You never find that. What we do find, though, it is because of our freedom, we are definitely walking the way of the Lord. We are to be walking for Him, but then we also ought to be doing. Like I say, my salvation is not a license to sin. Now, we preach and teach that Jesus paid for all sins. And you may be here today and say, well, what difference does it make if I sin a bunch? Well, it matters a lot. It matters a lot. Because the Bible said for us to stand fast. Jesus said, as he was looking to Simon Peter, he said, upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. That's what I've loved about this past week with Vacation Bible School, folks. We have been moving forward. We have been moving forward for the things of God. We've been moving forward with little boys and little girls that probably this week they heard more scripture and they heard more truth than they've ever heard in their life. Why? Because we're standing fast. We have been given a great freedom. But with that great freedom becomes a great responsibility, and we are taking that responsibility seriously. Seriously. He says, stand fast. So that's what we are to be doing, folks. Standing firm, taking life seriously, that the life that we have been given is the life that Jesus Christ died for on that cross for our sins. But then we see something else. We see we're a part of God's family. Now, for time's sake, we do not have time to go through the entire passage of Scripture here between verse 1 and verse number 13. I do encourage you, if you want to go back and look in that would be great. That would be wonderful. But I'm jumping to verse number 13. It says, for you, brethren, have been called to liberty. For you, brethren, have been called to liberty. What's that mean? You and I were called unto salvation. You and I were called unto salvation through the work and the power of the convicting Spirit, Holy Spirit of God. You were called unto salvation. Well, as you well know, Travis and Victoria and Logan and Gracie has been with us since June, and we'll be here to the end of this month, and not tonight, but a week from tonight, we will have their send-off and things here and have a dinner for them. If you have not signed up for that dinner, please do so, because we just need to know how many that we need to prepare for. Looking for a great night. But I've been in conversation with Gracie. Of course, you know, Gracie's 8 years old, you know. And we have some great conversations. She said, Dad, Charles, she said, I love Jesus, and I know Jesus loves me. She said, there's no question in my mind. I know that I love Jesus, and I know that Jesus loves me. But she said, Jesus has not asked me to be saved yet. She said, he has not asked me to be saved. She said, I don't know why. I don't know why, because I'm ready. I want to do that. But I have not felt the impression of the Holy Spirit of God. Now, this is 8-year-old talking, folks. That's why Paul said, for you, brethren, have been called. What is Gracie saying? I have not received the call. Holy Spirit hadn't said, you need him. You need him. For you, brethren, have been called to liberty, to freedom. But then he also gives something else for us today. As we look in this passage of Scripture, he says, don't indulge the flesh. That sinful nature. That fallen nature. That sinful nature that you and I deal with every day. I'm thankful that the sins of the sinful nature has been nailed to the cross. I'm very grateful for that. And I'm very grateful that because of my faith in Jesus Christ, the Bible says that we are a new creation in Christ Jesus. Even with those facts being stated, yet there is a prohibition that is given to us in the Word of God. It says, only do not use liberty, do not use freedom as an opportunity for the flesh. For the flesh. Taking advantage of the freedom in the wrong light. You see, true Christian freedom involves restraint. Restraint that helps, not hinders. Restraint that matures us in our Christian life, that we grow, but then also in our service to Jesus Christ. Now, we got to remember that we are free. We are free. Free from the penalty of sin. Free from the wrath of God. That we are free in Jesus Christ. Oh, today, the problems that we see in our country, they don't value the freedom. They don't value the freedom. The problems we see in our churches today, as believers in Jesus Christ, we do not value the freedom that we have. That we have. Paul said, don't use it as an opportunity for the flesh. Because if we use it for an opportunity for the flesh, we're not going to be honoring God. We're going to be honoring the old flesh. We're going to be honoring Satan and what that we do. You see, if we understand our freedom as a believer in Jesus Christ, just like this past week, you know, like I said, we started out with 125, I think, on Sunday night. We went to over 200 by the time Wednesday night got here because we saw it an important thing, planting the seeds of the gospel in the lives of boys and girls. And that's where evangelism is. It is a lifestyle, something that we do on a daily basis. And if we're going to be able to accomplish our work for Jesus Christ, if we are going to fulfill the purpose that God has given to us, we've got to look at our freedom in a complete different light. And believe me, if you don't look at your freedom, if you don't look at your freedom as a believer in Jesus Christ, it's not going to show. It is not going to show. Behind me stands two flags. Stands two flags. When we see one flag, we think of America, do we not? Because it is a symbol. The other one, we see the Christian flag, representing the kingdom of God in this world. One brotherhood, uniting all Christians in service and in love, as we say the pledge. It means something. Even though it's a symbol, it is a symbol of that which is greater. With that being said, we don't indulge in the flesh. We don't indulge in the flesh. Because when we indulge in the flesh, we are controlling our life and not Jesus Christ. Then also in our passage of Scripture, we see something else. Don't indulge in the flesh, but we are to serve in love. We are to serve God, and serve one another. For brethren, you've been called to liberty. Don't use it as a liberty to opportunity to indulge in the flesh, but through love, serve one another. You see, whenever we're in the flesh, a lot of times we're using people. And whenever we're using people for an act of the flesh. But whenever we look at our freedom in Jesus Christ, and we exercise that freedom in Jesus Christ, we're not going to be committing an act of the flesh, but we're going to be committing an act for God, an act of faith. And freedom directs us to do that. The freedom. Oh, today, when you think of the freedom of Christ, what comes to your mind? I can tell you one of the things that I think about. Whenever I think about the freedom of Christ, I think about the power of God. The power of God. I think of the old hymn that says, "All hail the power of Jesus' name." All hail His name. I think of songs like, "Would You Be Free from the Burden of Sin?" There was power in the blood. You see, whenever I read this Bible, I think of the Christian freedom. I think of the power that is in prayer. Also, I think of the power that is in the Word of God as I read it, as I need it daily. And that power in the Word of God gives me strength, gives me direction in my life. I think about the wonderful power that is in the blood of Jesus Christ. I also think of the power of God. I think the power that of Jesus Christ. I think of the power of the Holy Spirit of God. And you and I, we have access to that power because of our freedom that we have in Jesus Christ. So it's just more than me doing what I want to when I want to. But it's about being a believer in Christ and serving. Is this flag behind me of America? The flag is flown at a cost, has it not? The cost of lives of men and women serving this country. A high cost. A high cost. I look at this Christian flag and I see the cost for all Christians. That it cost the life of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ that we might have this freedom. And today, before us, we have the table of our Lord. And it is a symbol. As these two flags are symbols, what we have before us today, it is a symbol of the death, the burial, the resurrection of Jesus Christ. It is a symbol of the atonement, of the atoning work of Jesus Christ on the cross. On the cross. And it has been given to us to remember as a symbol. A symbol of a great gift. A symbol of a great freedom that we have. In just a moment, I'm going to have you come forward and pick up one of these cups. There's two cups in one. One has the bread on the bottom and then the cup with the juice in it. I'm going to ask you to just to come forward and then go back to your seat, and we will observe the Lord's table together. Together. And we will remember what Jesus Christ set aside for us. But these are the symbols. These are the symbols. Before we do that, let's go to the Lord in a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, as we bow before you, Father, we have a great freedom as a citizen of the United States, but we have a greater freedom in you. We'll only be a citizen of the United States for a limited amount of time, as long as this life shall last, but we will be a citizen of heaven forever, for all of eternity. And so, Father, we pray right now that you forgive us of our sin and all of our wrongs as we approach this table. We come to a time where we're going to look at the symbols that you have given to us. And so, Father, in this time of worship, we're not tied to a yoke of slavery, but freedom because of you. Help us, Father, to honor that right now. And we pray this in Jesus' name. And amen. Amen. I'm going to ask you, for those who desire you, to come forward. You may need to pick up for someone else. That is fine. If you need to pick up for someone that's not able to come forward today, and let us observe the table of our Lord together. You can take these cups, and if you twist one of them, sometimes it makes it a little easier to separate them. You hold in your hand the elements of the Lord's Supper. As we preach and teach and believe that they are symbols, symbols representing the body and the blood of Jesus Christ. And so as we look at these, we see a great price that was paid for your salvation and mine. Christ wanted us to remember that. Christ wanted us to remember of how that he laid his body down on that old rugged cross, how they took nails and they drove those nails into his hands and his feet, jarred that cross into the ground, and he suffered. His body suffered for you and for me. Let us hear the words of our Savior when he says, "Take, eat, this is my body." Then the second element, the grape juice, the fruit of the vine, as Jesus gave as a symbol of his precious blood. The Bible teaches that his blood was shed I hear the words of John the Baptist when he says, "Behold the Lamb of God, which takes away the sins of the world." He was a sacrificial lamb. He who knew no sin became sin for you and me, that we might be free. Free. He did that by shedding his precious blood. As Jesus looked at the disciples, he said, "This is the blood of the new covenant that I make with you." Let us hear the words of our Savior when he says, "Drink ye all of it." Let's pray. Dear Father, I thank you today for the flags that are upon the stage of what they represent. Because they represent of how that we can live our lives. Father, today I'm grateful for this table that we have been able to observe. That we do have a place at your table. Through salvation granted to us by Jesus Christ, because he has called us. We thank you, Lord, that you are a calling God, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. That is the desire of your heart. And Lord, we're thankful because we have received repentance in our life. And we belong to you. Lord, help us to love you more. Help us to love each other more. As we demonstrate our freedom in this world. We pray these things in Jesus' name. And amen. Will you stand as we sing together?
If you made the decision today to receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, we want to celebrate that new start with you. Please call our church office at 270-527-9696 so we can encourage you on your new journey. If you are in need of prayer, we have prayer partners waiting to join in praying for you. Please call our church office at 270-527-9696. Again, that's 270-527-9696. Thank you for being part of our service today. Our prayer at Zion's Cause is that this service drew you closer to the Lord Jesus Christ. We look forward to you joining us again next week. On behalf of the pastor, staff, and congregation, may God richly bless you and keep you. This has been a production of Zion's Cause Baptist Church.